Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Totalbiscuit. I'm here to ask and answer one simple question. WTF is 30 Flights of Loving. Sounds like a bad porno. It's a sequel to Gravity Bone, which sounds like a bad porno. Comes from Blendo Games. And in collaboration with Idle Thumbs, one of my favorite gaming podcasts. That's kind of cool. The music is done by Chris Remo. Gravity Bone was a free game. This costs $5 or your regional equivalent. It's described as a gaming short story. I want to ask one question, though. Even though this is apparently a very short game, will someone please explain to me why it's got this many options and why full budget releases don't? I'm sorry, but you should be embarrassed if you happen to be a major developer or publisher when you've got... Look at the list. Look at it all. Look at all of this stuff you can do. I can activate all of these wonderful things. I don't know what half of them mean, but I can activate them. Am I right? Yes, indeed I am. There you go. Wow, wonderful. All right. So, this is the sequel to Gravity Bone. Gravity Bone, if I recall correctly, can be beaten in about 8 minutes. So let's just do them both. Because I just have a feeling I'm not going to understand 30 Flights of Loving if I don't do Gravity Bone. So you know what? Let's do Gravity Bone and then we'll go on to 30 Flights of Loving and try and figure out what the hell's going on. Gravity Bone, onward. Well, it's wonderfully stylized, as you might imagine, with fantastic big band music in the background. Welcome to the Saturday Club Business Initiative. And onward we go to the furnace room. One could say that this party is somewhat full of squares. Am I right, guys? Yes? Nah, I will be in the furnace room, shoving my head into the furnace. It's probably for the best. Onward to the furnace room, yes. Don't you dare clip through me. It's quite frankly a disgraceful and horrendous activity. Well, we'll have a quick leap and a skip and a bound, if we so desire. Space to jump. Let us find what we can find. Oh! What could it possibly be? Deliver this something to this something. Is that red text on red background? Truly an artistic choice. On we go. The big band music continues to play, and suddenly I feel less joyous about the whole thing. Oh yes, I also completely forgot what I was doing. I was supposed to deliver this to the man in the something. Let me guess, there's probably no objective screen, all things considered. Why did I not pay attention? Why? Paying attention requires far too much effort, evidently. My career in the Gravity Bone has already been ruined by the fact that I cannot follow basic instructions. What I'm doing is extending the length of the game for you. Since it clearly only lasts for about 8 minutes. I am staff. Thank you. There you go. I look like staff, I smell like staff, I am very clearly staff. The man with the red... I can't even read the remainder of this sodding thing. It's at the wrong angle. Oh well. I'd love to say that I can very clearly hear what he's saying in the background, but I cannot at all, so never mind. The man with the red something. Alright. Onward we go. Yes, somehow I think it might be that guy. Greetings. Have this, you'll probably die horribly. Lord knows why there are so many seaplanes. That's probably for the best that we don't know. Find the exit. Let us do just that. Well, what a wonderfully linear experience we're currently having. The music is wonderful. That I can very clearly say. Where is the exit? That looks like the exit. Outward we go. Thank you. I'm sorry, folks, but I have to split. Your party is just quite frankly too dull for me.
Congratulations. The Manitoba Beast Bug placed into the wine glass was successfully delivered to the target individual. With persistence and ingenuity, we can detect the Manitoba Beast Bug's gloomy gases and track the target individual across the galaxy. By the clients are pleased.
One of us. Of course. How foolish of me to suggest otherwise. Extended play indeed. Alright, let us continue then, shall we? through the remainder of the 10 or so minutes of Gravity Bone, and then we can try 30 Flights of Lovin'. Go to the furnace room, which is inexplicably clipping in this direction. All right. To the furnace room indeed. Well, we're not going that way. Hello. How it... Just, hang on. This... You have the same voice. Wow, okay. That's a little disturbing. You might want to go see a doctor about that. To the inexplicable stomping room. Why is that even there? Why is that even there? Someone please explain that to me. Don't tell me this goes back to the start. No, it does not. Wonderful. Wonderful. That was a little concerning, to say the least. Okay, that's where I'm going. No. They're speaking in tongues. They are possessed. What is the easiest way to get through here? There we go. That would do the trick. Yeah, we got the whole space bar to jump thing. It's actually of no use here whatsoever, as far as I can tell. Ah, I see. Yoink. There we go. She'll have the hammer and the pressurized freon, which we'll no doubt use to get through locks, one would think. There we go. Switch the hammer and then smack it around a little bit. Not an especially difficult game up to this point. It's more of a proof of concept than anything else. It's got a very intriguing design to it. Of course. That shouldn't be a problem. Let us find those five birds, then. I'm interested to know where this is actually going. I'm not truly seeing the point of it thus far. It's like I'm possibly missing some kind of very clever metaphor. And I feel... stupider and stupider, but then of course I could just be completely overthinking it. Bird acquired. Lord knows why they're being kept in the room with the missile warning sign upon it. Kind of secret plan, no doubt. Ah! Well, I guess that answers that question. Any more birds for me? Truly, the innovation and wondrous game mechanics are impressing me here. I'll have you. It does very much seem like a proof of concept. Now, which direction are we going in? Please don't tell me this could be used as a jetpack or something along those lines. That would just be silly. No, it cannot. Oh, all right, well... basic first-person platforming, just what I was looking for in this experience. Why did I do that? Of all of the things that I should have done, that was not high up on the list. Thank you for at least loading me back into the area that I was looking for. That's a good thing indeed. Bear in mind that... damn it! Bear in mind that Gravity Bone is a free game, by the way. This just comes as part of 30 Flights of Lovin', which is supposedly the sequel to Gravity Bone. Continuing on this wonderful story of bird photography. Really? Wonderful story of bird photography and weaponized poultry. Doesn't seem like anything remotely unusual there. There we go. I hate that. It seems like it's so much thinner than it really is. The jumping is not accurate at all. But I think I'd be kind of missing the point of the game if I was talking about how good the jumping puzzles were. Not that I can figure out the point of the game to begin with, but hey. I'll take us back to the furnace room. Pop in here, shall we? Nope, that's also back in the furnace room. Not too interested in what's going on in there. So head out back in this direction. I have a feeling I missed something. Yes, I very much did. Everything. Thank you very much. This is going to turn into more of a let's play, isn't it? This is the problem with a game that's clearly so short. And its sequel, which is also apparently very, very short. You essentially can't do anything else. And that's, I edited the DRS the video... pretty intensely, but that's because that game drags on for about an hour and has maybe about 2 minutes of interesting gameplay. Okay, that's a lie. It has no minutes of interesting gameplay. Well, let's find the exit then, shall we? It's most likely back through the furnace room, being my theory. At which point you'll no doubt get horribly squashed and complain repeatedly. Looks like she just takes us back in this direction. There we go. Yes, the five birds have been successfully photographed. Thank you very much. Just back in this direction. The question is there a way to just get back to the exit? I'm not actually seeing any signs for the exit, which is ever so slightly unhelpful. No exit, no exit, no exit. And once again, no actual exit. This is extending the lifespan of the game through my own ineptitude. We could do the jumping puzzle again and see if it was up there. Maybe are those air vents actually relevant? No, they are not. You can't reach them, so never mind. Da-da-da! I think this is the kind of game that you create when you've got an interesting idea and just don't quite have enough gameplay to flesh it out. You put out what's essentially a short story or concept. Which is okay, especially when it's free, but I think the question is when we eventually look at 30 Flights of Love and after we've finished Gravity Bone, as to whether or not the game is actually worth playing as a game itself. Oh, that was the way into the furnace room. That's the way to the back of the furnace room. One would assume that the exit would be here. That would be logical. And there it is. Oh, wonderful. Slight navigational is... Oh, hello. Well, you're not a very nice person at all, are you? So much for that. Well, I guess that might be the end of Gravity Bone. You know, I spent an awful lot of effort on that. And I would have certainly preferred if you didn't steal it from me. We can try and chase her down. Well, you know, I've only got 3 or 4 bullet wounds in me, so I'm sure this should be absolutely fine. She also appears to be on skis. I guess I shouldn't be surprised by that. I do rather love the music, though. There's no question about that. The mechanics allow me to actually speed myself... Oh, Lord. I was going to say speed myself up there, but I should have dashed in that direction. An autosave, perhaps? A short game, but certainly full of hazards, no doubt. It does give the interesting, authentic spy experience. I'd abuse the game engine to increase my speed beyond what should be possible. Oh, bollocks. Even increasing my speed beyond what should be possible is still going to not get me there in time anyway, so hey. Abuse the game engine, abuse the game engine. Perhaps just dodge out of the way. Might be a good idea. Common sense, yes. Rarely, if ever, common in my experience. Do come back here. I'd like to take you on a holiday to Tipperary. Kind of image that this music evokes in my mind. So, how's the weather? Please come back and give me my camera. It has precious holiday memories. What's wrong with you? Also, if you could return my intestines in an intact fashion, that would also be wonderful. Just, no, get back here. Oh dear. I'm flattening the compote. Just, yes I was, and why did I even consider jumping in that direction? I'm gonna be clever and increase my speed against the game engine. You know, for a 7-minute game, I surely have managed to completely balls it up, haven't I? Right, get back here. There's probably no point in speeding myself up, because the game clearly doesn't want me to catch this woman until an appropriately predetermined time. No, I'm not going to stand all over the compote. I'm going to stand here and wait for you. Oh, it doesn't trigger. Never mind then. I guess I am chasing you. Come on, back you go. Thank you. Da-da-da-da-da-da. What a wonderfully whimsical adventure we have here. It's hard to actually God damn it. Why would I fall for that again? This is scripted me to be a damn idiot. Was that a... I'm just thinking whether or not that was a reference to The Godfather. My life is flashing before my square eyes. A life well wasted, perhaps. Are we quite finished? Anytime now. This... Obviously. Why not? A track meet, of course. How foolish of me. Welcome to the end of Gravity Bone. What the hell just happened? So hopefully this provides some kind of a prologue for 30 Flights of Lovin', but I'm not entirely convinced by that. Okay, 30 Flights of Lovin'. There's also a developer commentary, which no doubt explains it, but I'm not, you know, I'm not going to show you the developer commentary, because since this game seems very much a linear storytelling experience as opposed to anything else, although at least it actually has gameplay in it, which is more like Save a Dear Esther, I think that showing the developer commentary would kind of defeat the point of the exercise. 30 Flights of Lovin', okay. Does this at least explain something? So, I am clearly a spy. Horrible things happened. My camera was stolen. I was shot to death because I'm a goddamn idiot. The name of my character was Citizen Abel. This helps me not in any way, shape, or form. And that, actually, is, if I recall correctly, part of... Yeah, it was. It was an image from Atom Zombie Smasher. Oh, well, never mind. Well, this is 30 Flights of Lovin', which is essentially the same thing with better lighting effects by the looks of it. Willkommen auf Superberg. I don't know what willkommen means, but... As they cynically look on, I'm going to steal all of their moderately priced bourbon. The disappointment in their eyes is very clear to see. It bores into my very being. That's actually maple syrup. That is why they're that is where the disappointment comes from. Clearly, I did not notice. Also, he appears to be getting ready to go scuba diving. Either that or it's a very interesting choice of modeling. Still looks better than Minecraft. Into the secret room we go. Whatever language that is, I can't read it, so I'm not even going to bother. Can I jump to my death? I can attempt to, but no, my sad little life must continue. I opened the door and entered this particular armory, consisting of a very strange, squinty-beard man. And this woman right here appears to be armed to the teeth. Demolitions, mechanic, sharpshooter, and confectioner, naturally. Character development in progress over the course of about 3 seconds. Now I feel I know these men much better. I acquired the moonshine on the table, opened up the box of bullets, and took them all for no apparent reason, considering I don't seem to have an inventory of any actual real sense. Zoomed in on the coffee mugs for no apparent reason, but I need to stop narrating this and start trying to figure out what the hell's going on. And in this case, it almost seems like some of these actually do... All of this is telling a story in some respect, I'm just not quite picking up on it. No, thank you. Alright, well, we appear to be part of some kind of special operations team, which may or may not be attempting to create confectionery for a nearby wedding. Did I see ducks up there? Can I acquire the ducks? The ducks are repulsed by my very presence. It's a very common occurrence in my daily life. Evidently, I don't like water either, it would seem. I'm intrigued to know what's actually going to end up going on here, and also what the obsession with bloody seaplanes is in this series. Into the seaplane we go. We shall be joined by two faithful compadres. One of which is bringing marzipan to the table, the other one, cynical good looks. Alright. Just in case you didn't know, this is not real. Nita has evidently been shot fairly horribly. I have to wonder if I was the one to actually... She seems like she's thinking that I was the person responsible for this, so I have to wonder if that happened. I wonder what happened to the 22 bottles of maple syrup that I was carrying around. That's probably the very reason why we're dead in the first place. We'll bring our bearded friend along with us into the airport. Nobody seems to notice the bleeding, bearded man that I'm carrying on my shoulder. Cameras and the balloons. What? Is this deliberately edited for time or something along those lines? I have no idea. Yes, it is. I think that's interesting. I think they're actually making cuts in the same way that you would see in a movie, just to kind of save time, create a montage of sorts. An intriguing idea. I'm glad that he isn't paying any sodding attention. No doubt this entire thing is full of references. I've yet to see the Great Gatling Gunsby as of yet, but no doubt a million and one Idle Thumbs references all over the place. Alright, so we made our way over in this direction, and now I am having a little bit of a nap, one has to assume. Well, that's still Anita, who is at this point not full of bullet holes, which is always wonderful. I have acquired the Satsuma. It's a very odd way of telling a story, isn't it? It really, really is. I don't actually think I've ever seen anything like that before in a video game. The way that it just skips forward in a really jarring manner. It's an intriguing idea, certainly. At least it's not as ridiculously pretentious as Dear Esther is. It actually has some gameplay to some degree. Although only, I think, a functional amount. Also, at least the graphic style kind of charms me in a way. I feel like I want to know what actually happens here. I'm not being constantly fed narration after narration after narration, slow movement and things like that, even though the game is evidently highly scripted. I still have the Satsuma. I guess I'm going to be the life of the party by the looks of it. She's bringing confectionery, he's bringing the booze, and I'm bringing a single Satsuma. And no, I did not bring enough for the entire class. What a wonderful, wonderful world we live in. She clearly cares not for my Satsuma. Eat it. Just get it in your... I feel incredibly friend-zoned at this stage. This reminds me of a terrible Family Guy scene. I walked into the kitchen and sat down at the table. I looked with a grimace at the questionable meal Lois had placed in front of me. Of course, I'd never tell her how disgusted I was with her cooking, but somehow I think she knew. Lois had always been full of energy and life, but lately I'd begun to grow more aware of her aging. The bright, exuberant eyes that I'd fallen in love with were now beginning to grow dull and listless with the long fatigue of a weary life. I woke several hours later in a daze. Yeah, I am as confused as you are, don't worry. I really do need to actually watch the developer commentary to figure out what the balls is going on in this thing. Alright, let's head back downstairs. It's okay, I've still got the Satsuma, so we are protected. A drunken haze. Why, hello. Well, of course. How foolish of me. I was back to the... I guess that was a flashback of some description. My legs are horribly broken, but I still have the Satsuma, so all is good with my life. Probably not even a Satsuma, it's some kind of metaphor. Skipping backwards and forwards all over the place, it's really quite confusing. Yes, I'm seeing the references all over the place at this stage. And an advertisement for Quadrilateral Cowboy, which is Blendo's new game, I might add, coming in your direction. If this one hasn't put you off for life already. It's... I'm just really, really curious as to what's going on. I think at least you've got a little bit of replayability here, trying to figure out what the hell is supposed to be happening. Well, that's one way to use it, I guess. Thank you. Yes, I am a smart man. Would you like this Satsuma? Was it really necessary to have a loading screen there? Was it really necessary? I have to wonder if they deliberately put that in. For some reason. Or maybe I'm just overthinking it. All I know is I'm really, really enjoying the soundtrack. So once again, Chris Remo with a masterwork. We like it. It is a trap. Clearly horrible things are about to occur. In this game, we didn't bother to play shooting mechanics because your friend can do it for you. Oh, it's the birds as well. Flying in formation with a curious amount of musical integrity and harmonics, I have to say. The hell is going on? I certainly can't explain it. A wonderful symphony of flavor and maniacal homicidal birds. But everything is fine, because I still have the Satsuma. I wonder if I was even supposed to bring this in here in the first place. Because textures are for the weak. I am certainly being told a story here, I can definitely say that. I think I'm getting the idea of what's going on. Although the amount of jumping around it does is truly confusing. I think play through it a few times to figure out what's going on there. The birds. There's five of them as well, just like the sodding gravity bone in the first place. Alright then. This explains nothing! I guess welcome to the end. What the hell? I don't know, I don't even feel like I've necessarily wasted my money here because I just spent the last 25 minutes trying to figure out what the hell I was spending my time doing. And for me, actually $5 is, that's fine, that's a good price for that kind of experience. I still have the Satsuma. Yes. I feel like I'm too stupid to fully appreciate this. This is the kind of thing I need to sit down with a glass of cognac and a cigarello and figure out what the balls is going on with it. The hell? When is the end? Not the end! Now it's the end. And I still have my Satsuma. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Gravity Bone followed by 30 Flights of Lovin'. Oh, you can peel it. I never realized you could do that. And it was as delicious as I would have expected. The anticipation and the build-up to whatever the hell just happened. Oh, Blendo Games. I will never truly understand you. This is currently available on Steam. I'm just not really sure why. See you next time.